Morning everyone. Today I am going to take a lecture of discrete mathematics chapter number 1, set theory. We have already seen in our previous lecture how we use the Venn diagram according to your set theory. So this is the next example is A intersection B intersection C is equal to A minus bracket open A minus B union A minus C. Okay, so we solve this question, you can select this condition with the help of Venn diagram. Okay, so always keep in mind, first with the help of the Venn diagram, if we use the Venn diagram according to our question, so first you draw the rectangle, this is your universal set, and after that you draw here in the circle. Okay, so here, first we write here the image sign. So first we draw the rectangle, this is your universal set, okay, and we write here A, B and C. Okay, so here we find out the A intersection B intersection C. So what do you mean by the A intersection B intersection C? That is the common element according to all these three sets. Okay, so according to this diagram, the common area is what? This area. This area is what? A intersection B intersection C. Because of this portion, A part, this portion also including B, and this portion also included in the C. So this is your images. The diagram is this. A intersection B intersection C. Next one is we use here the RHS. Okay, so RHS, first we find out the A minus B. So A minus B, that means what? The elements of the set A. So, the elements of the set B is not included in the set A. So, this is your set A. Here, you ignore the B. Here, you ignore the set C, C circle. Okay. So, not in B. B not included in the set A. So, we draw here this. Okay. This is your what? This is your A minus B. Okay, next one is A minus C. That means what? Here you ignore the circle B. So A minus C, that means what? The elements of C not present in the set A. So here we draw this type. Okay, but here C is not included in this shaded area. Okay, here B portion is not included and here C portion is not included in the shaded area. Next one is what? Next one is we draw here A minus B union A minus C. That means this is your A minus B and this is your A minus C. And union of these two diagrams, that means what? We include all the shaded area. So here this portion is already included this point. That means this and this area. So here hold the A and this point, only this point we ignore here. Okay, so A minus B union A minus C is equal to what? This is this type of the area. Okay, A minus B union B A minus C. Okay, we draw here this point and here this point. So union, that means all the elements included in A minus B union A minus C. Okay, so next one is what? Next one is A minus all this portion we subtract from the element set A. So this is your set A. Okay, this is your set A and we ignore all this area. This is your set A. This is your, this circle is your set A. Okay, and you ignore all this area. So remaining area is what? Remaining area is this. So we draw here. Okay, so here for the 1, 2, 3, 4 and the 5. So first and fifth, see here, first and fifth both the diagrams are equal. Okay, then we can say that we satisfied this condition. Okay, next one is the A ring sum B. So here A ring sum B is equal to what? We have already seen in our previous lecture, A union B minus A intersection B. Okay, this is the formula of the A ring sum B. So what is the diagram? So diagram is, first we draw here the universal set because of when we use the Venn diagram. So always keep in mind, you write here first in the universal set. Okay, so here we draw first, second and third, three circles A, B and C. Okay, so A usually that is this shaded area, and A intersection B that is this shaded area. So what do you mean by this is A? So the meaning is that A union B, so you subtract this A intersection B area, that means A in some B is equal to what? Is equal to, you ignore the intersection area. Okay, and otherwise you write here all the shaded area. So this is the example of the A rays of B. So here you ignore the C circle, because of here we don't have any C set, because of we use only the two number of sets. Okay, so this is the diagram of the A rays of B. That means you ignore here this C circle. Okay, because of here we use only the A and B. So next example is A ring sum, B ring sum C. The B ring sum C divided in the bracket is equal to A ring sum B in the bracket. After that we write here the ring sum C. Okay, so with the help of Venn diagram, first we draw here the LHS. Okay, so LHS first we draw B ring sum C. So what do you mean? So don't be confused here. If you use the Venn diagram according to your question and your question given in the ring sum form, so always use in the Venn diagram, because of with the help of Venn diagram we find out very easily of this condition. Because of if we use these two sets in, and use the operation in the ring sum, so always the common area, you ignore the common area and the remaining area you schedule it. So B ring sum C, that is this is your B and this is your C. So we write here this is your B, okay, and this is your C. Got it? Next one is, this is your B ring sum C, ignore the circle. Next one is the A ring sum, B ring sum C. That means what? This is your B ring sum C. And you write here the A ring sum. So always the common area, you ignore the common area, and the remaining area you shade it all these values. Okay. So here you draw the A ring sum in the bracket B ring sum C. Okay. So all the common area you ignore it, and the remaining area you shade it here. Okay. So this is the Venn diagram of the A ring sum B ring sum C. Okay, next one is the RHS sign. So here RHS, first we find out the A ring sum B. Okay, so this is your A and this is your B. Okay, so in the A and B, the common area is this area. So you ignore this area and the remaining area you shade it here. So you shade it here A ring sum B. Okay, and here ignore the circle C. Okay, you ignore here the circle C. So this is the A ring sum B. Okay, this is your common area. Next one is the A ring sum B ring sum C. That is, this is your A ring sum B and this is your C. So again, you ignore this common area because of this is included in the C circle. So here you draw the shaded area and ignore all the common area according to your A circle, B circle and the C circle, or you can select A set, B set and the C set. Got it? So this is very easily we find out the ring sum, because of the Venn diagram is very easy. We solve that this type of the question. Okay, so see here, this is your first and this is your second diagram, this is your third and this is your fourth diagram. So according to second and fourth, both the diagrams are same. That means this is the associativity law. A ring sum, B ring sum, C is equal to V. Change of places is what? We write here only the bracket. A ring sum, B ring sum, C is equal to first we in the bracket we write here the A ring sum B and after that ring sum C. That means this is the SOCPP law and we find out very easily with the help of Venn diagram. So this is some basic set identities. So here we have A, B, C, three subset of set X. Then the first property is idempotent law. So the idempotent law that means A union A is equal to A and A intersection A is equal to A. This is the idempotent law. Second one is the commutative law. So A union B is equal to B union A and A intersection B is equal to B intersection A. This is the commutative law. Next one is the associative law. Okay, so associative law here A union B union C is equal to A union B union C. Okay, next one is A intersection B intersection C is equal to A intersection B intersection C. This is the associativity law. Only change the bracket. Okay, next one is the distributive law. We have already seen in the associative law, in the distributive law, depends on a problem with the help of the Venn diagram, we solve this type of the question. Okay, next one is the distributive law. So, first one is A union B intersection C is equal to A union B intersection A union C. Okay, next one is A intersection B union C is equal to A intersection B union A intersection C. Okay, this is your distributive law. Next one is the De Morgan's law. De Morgan's law very important and very interesting. A union B dash is equal to A dash intersection B dash. We already seen this type of the formula in the semester third, probability and the statistics. Okay, A intersection B dash is equal to A dash union B dash. Okay, next one is the absorption law. So A union B intersection B is equal to A and A intersection A union B is also A. Okay, last one is the double complement. So double complement, that means what? A dash dash is equal to A. Okay, so this is the basic law, depend on the set identities. First one is the idempotent law, second one is the commutative law, third one is the associativity, fourth one is the distributive law, fifth is the De Morgan's law, next one is the absorption law, and last one is the double complement. Okay, so I will continue this topic in our next lecture. Thank you.